I'm about to freak this. Ha 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 ha. What, 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 what? Big well. I'm about to freak this. What you want me to freak this? Just peep it while I freak this. Aye. I'm about to freak this, full out the king of the hill, Big Will, keeping it real, knees in the grill, the whole set on lockdown, making you flock down to where I'm at, to hear my rap, I be that cat that set trends, where y'all at, on the corner with your friends, heard you screaming about cream in your rap, yeah, yo, my last check for Wild Wild West came on a flatbed, once and for
big
all, let's get
quality,
this
unentangled titties lacking entanglement, there is no mix-up, there's no, I don't know, left from right, up from down. And not all. I just felt like we needed that energy. We needed good Will Smith. We about to freak this energy. And that's what we got, folks. We'll get into things. How y'all doing? How's everybody doing? You guys having a good time? You guys been hearing all the good news and just different views and perspectives about relationships and so on and so forth. A big week for black love. That's what Will and Jada gave us a lot to talk about at some point today. But on this YouTube search that I did so I could get like some music to start the day, Will's hip hop journey was wild. Like, we let a lot of shit slide in, like, the early 2000s. Like, a lot of these big, bright red, puffy jacket outfits, red head to toe. This yellow fucking, it's this weird yellow and black fucking outfit. He's a snow outfit. It was just a lot. And, like, that was just a time where, like, we got away just because, you know, we're the black. Like, we just set the tone in anything fashionable. But niggas was really just wearing, like, goggles on your arm and shit. What a time. This is the Will we're going to get back to, though, folks. All right? You know, we've been sitting here watching Will jump off buildings and fucking ice skate in the Alps on top of a mountain or whatever while giving inspirational speeches and having movies with, like, $80 billion budgets and shit. But now it's going to be like real, real intense Philly energy. I know y'all saw, everybody I feel like their mama has seen this interview now, a Red Table Talk. You brought yourself to the table, but it was Will's Red Table. It was a lot going on. And I know there's a part that everybody keeps like pointing out that Will's like, I'm going to get you back though. And we're, you know, I feel like we're now looking, I don't know, what if there's like a super secret evil Will? Because I was about to take this towards like that freaking it, I'm going to Miami. Like, and then freaking it, he like had a bar about like, I dare y'all to write a rap without cursing. So I'm like, damn, is this like the highest form of like angry Will that we'll get? Like, we're going to go all the way back to fucking getting jiggy with it. And then you'll be sorry, Jada. Like, the peak Will anger is like, you know, like, damn, can't have this nigga go to Miami on me or some shit. Fuck. But what if there's like some deep dark Will? What if Will is like a really just aggressive, just thug ass nigga that nobody knows? And we've been sitting here watching these goddamn, you know, self-empowerment, mindfulness Will on Instagram and breaking fucking technology boundaries and shit. Because every day there's a fucking like super duper. And then Will's like, man, you fucking up the church's money. And I'm going to have to get real Philly gangster fucking Will Smith. Gangster Will Smith. Is that scary to anybody else? Like if like Will was just this fucking, because, you know, clearly like they got like a lot of like secretive shit. This has been, you know, fucking their relationship has been on the fucking ether of, well, I guess, well, weird might be a bad word, of non-traditional shit. So we don't know what the fuck Will got going on. Honestly, Will could be scarier than Benny Siegel. Like, he could be really just the scariest nigga in Philly and nobody knows anything else or none the wiser. Waiting on Will to just fucking I don't know, lose his shit. Or I don't know, because once again, there was like a meme. A meme was out, and it was, I think I posted it to like a podcast page. And the meme was like, or not a meme, it was a tweet, my bad. And the tweet was about how, like, Will wasn't sad, because all the jokes now are like, you know, sad Will got, you know, his heart hurt. But what if Will was like really cool with this arrangement? Like, what if Will is like, you know, like, what if it's not, you know, Jada, like, just, first of all, nobody can tell me, whatever, whatever. Will's like, I don't give a shit, bro. What I give a shit about is you bringing all this motherfucking shit to the house. Like, I don't give a fuck who you, what you, I was through. Like, I was done. Like, I think Will might be like, dog, like, I'm fucking, you know, I was the highest paid actor at some one point. Like, I was almost Neo. Like, you really need to leave me the fuck alone. And, like, all you had to do was vet your nigga. Like, you, we got one job and how we, like, assort and run this family structure. And you came in here. You knew the rules. You didn't, you know, you didn't do no background checks on this nigga. Like, you just got niggas out here saying shit, doing shit, looking silly, fucking it up for the household. I don't know. I've been flirting with that theory that Will might not just be this, you know, walking puddle of tears, sad, you know, I don't know. I don't want to. I'm not gonna lie. I pulled the joke right now. I'm fucking with Will, but I don't want to say no harsh shit. I love Will. I love Will Smith, but. Yeah, like that maybe he's not like just super sad about it. He's just like, man, this is, you fucking this up. You fucking up the horse shit that is our whatever, like, arrangement or our family or whatever. And yeah, I don't know. There's been like, you know, everybody, like there's tons of commentary out about it. But I do think there's like a conversation now. I was watching the Joe Budden podcast, and there's like the idea that, you know, not to say that, you know, you can't have your side people or however you arrange your relationship, but that there's a potential, there's an angle where there might be like, you know, predatory Jada. Like, you know, you're supposed to have an individual, you're supposed to you know, be like a safe space mentally, and then it's like, ah, but the dick as well, because, like, crazy dick. Like, you know, you niggas out here got sane dick, but you get you some dick, you know, with some mental illness attached to it, man. And that's crazy, you know. You don't know who you in here fucking. It's Monday, it's angry fucking. Tuesday, it's trauma fucking. Wednesday, we actually in love. It's fucking, what a roller coaster, what a ride, you know. So, I don't know. I think that's something to... Not to, you know, not to just shit on her. Because I do see a lot of, like, a lot of dudes on the other side. Like, you know, you those out here be cheating. It's like, nigga, everybody be cheating. But I think that there is a potential angle where, like, you know, Red Talk Table Jada. Jada's this, I don't know if she has any background in, like, mental health or anything like that. But she does have, like, a space where it's very talkative, very open, very all these other things about your feelings, and that's pretty much the entire thing of, like, what the sidebar. Actually, I mean, I think it's a good move, whatever, for their business-wise, but I think they got cool little balls, like, as a family to go, oh, no, we're going to just get ahead of this and do this on our own platform as opposed to, like, avoiding it, dodge, duck, dip, dive, and dodging it. So I think that's, like, a cool-ass move. I mean, you know, for whatever. I mean, people still feel how they feel about it. But, yeah, they're just, like, you know, like, get in front of it, take control of the situation, all that shit. Can't nobody really fuck you over if you tell your own story. So, yeah. But I do think that there was, like, at least in the part, I only saw, like, there's, like, I don't know if it was, like, one of these long ones or if it was that little, like, as long as the clip, because it was like a 14, 15 minute clip that was on like YouTube or some shit, and that's all I watched. But, yeah, I think there is a, I don't know. I think there is a lane where you could kind of go like, hey, you know, like, you knew bro was not crazy. You knew he had his mental illness. You knew, you know, especially if he was ever as transparent as he was in the interview with like Yee, where you could tell, like, whether you have a background in there, if you just, you know, armchair therapist person, you just think you know some shit about some shit. It's like, bro mentioned a variety of times, like, mother issues and you know, issues growing up. And, you know, so there's all these, like, needs that he needs felt. And you're an older woman. You're, you know, wise. You give him all these other, like, safe environments where it's like, all right, man, like, that was your responsibility to not, like, you could fuck anybody. Like, you're, you know, Jada Pinkett Smith. You're in one of the fucking, you know, most known families pretty much out. Everybody a fucking star in their own right in some way or another. And it's like, my nigga, like, you could have fucked anybody. So in that realm, I think there's a, it's a tad bit on the predatory side, just, or maybe, I don't know. Predatory is a little aggressive of a word, but still, it's like, you knew this person needed, like, help, and you kind of abused your position in that motherfucker's life to go, oh yeah, you know what I'm finna get now? Some dick. When you know, you should do that. That's a rock. Damn, that dog came in like, wow, perfect shirt is fucking perfect. Damn, that's a perfect ass shirt. I'm actually 100% envious. Wow. That is, yeah. Dirt, that is, he's, fuck out of fighting. Like, Master Roshi is a legendary dirt.
Master Roshi is top-notch king of pervery.
I'm fucking with it. I mean, we're in the ballpark. I jumped straight into the nonsense of pervery. And
oh, so we're talking about overage pervery at the minute. So Master Roshi fits perfectly, right?
Yeah, we are. I mean, I was still dancing in the, you know, he was crazy. There's a realm where we can have the conversation of, was this, you know, predatory? Because you know, in the interview, it's like, I was in a bad space. I'm like, I know you could have been, and I'm not saying you weren't, but I'm also saying there's a bit of a, because you do this, like, you if to watch even that like, I literally just said this, that part where it's like, where he had the interview with Angela Yee, like, over that whole thing, you could tell it's like, mental health, you have a lot of things. But there was one thing he mentioned a lot of his issues with his mom. So I was like, you're an older woman, I'm pretty sure he told you this, so you now kind of can understand your space in his life. And granted, you probably may have had a bad time, but, you know, you went straight to, I'm a fucking.
And Jada did exactly what a lot of us men do.
Yep.
And even get chastised for doing. It's like,
Joe,
you thinking
said,
with
oh,
you thinking
oh,
with your dick, right?
Oh,
like,
you got
it's an issue with men,
dick
right? It's an issue when men, quote unquote, think with their dick and still mess with the crazy chick just because she look good. But, you know, this is the first time it's actually having a woman be on the receiving end of that. So I kind of like it, even though I don't agree with everything. I just like it just for the sake of equality.
Yeah, I like the equality part. I like that now people have to have, let's have, like, we're just going to bust all these conversations
open, just now.
Cause
Chris Jericho, break the walls down. God,
yeah, because as much as, and I take nothing back that we said, I definitely still think Aug should have kept his mouth shut.
No doubt.
But I think there are conversations where it's like, hey, you know, now dudes can hurt. So now we have that conversation. That
did you
hurt.
Learn nothing from Pleasure P? He said, boyfriend number two, what are you supposed to do? Like, you supposed to stay in your lane.
Still, he, like, broke a lot of rules.
Yeah, man.
I mean, they put on, you know, and I know that they're, the Smith thing is like a brand and shit now, so I do feel like, you know,
you fucking up the brand.
Yeah, like, I feel like that part from, like, Will's perspective was like a lot of, like, we do really well in this. We talk about our stuff space, but my nigga, like, wow,
you brought him in here and messed it up, and now I got to get revenge on you. Now I got to get you back.
Yeah, everybody,
because you messing up the check for the whole household.
Yeah, it was a lot of, like, sad will, and I'm like, I don't know. Like, there's a couple ways that could be looked at, because everybody's taking the sad will approach, and I've heard things where it's like, you know, like we've talked about, like, you know, still loves Pac. Will might not even want to be in that type of whatever, but he loves Jada. She's got love for him, and it's just like, this is a good situation for her, for him. He might be over the wall, madly in love, and might really hate this setup, but he wants to stay with his wife in whatever way he can. I've heard that, and I've heard that conversation a lot, but there is the idea that, man, fucking Will might be a goddamn just fucking assassin. Like, all right, like, I want you to know you fucked up. Like, I give a shit about this show. I give a shit about how you fucked up. All right. And now,
I mean, I think we can kind of notice that within the whole clip of the exchange with him and Jada where he's telling her, like, you know, I got to get you back. She's like, no, no, you've done that plenty of times. He's like, yeah, but no. Mm. So I think, and even like what I think a lot of people kind of missed is like when they were speaking about their time apart, like Will said, like, yeah, I was sick of your shit. And Jada agreed, like, yeah, you were tired of me. And I was going through my, like, Jada admitted that she was probably the reason why they weren't doing so well at that point in time. And then she took it upon herself to, I won't say make it worse because I don't know their relationship, so I don't really know how it affects it. But case in point, all this is all because of you. And Will should be like a saint because he's just sat back throughout this whole ordeal, which has lasted, say, two, almost 3 years, and just been like, okay.
Yeah, I just...
This is the pinnacle of peace throughout all of this.
Yeah, just like that. I just feel like, yeah, you just... I don't know. It just still seems like a bit of a knee-jerk move. I mean, I know you... We're done with each other, so you have the realm and right to move with whoever you want. But whoever the fuck Will was moving and swimming with, them motherfuckers was like, look, he was neuralizing the motherfuckers at the end. Like, this was great. Look at this light real quick. Don't fuck up my shit. Go the fuck on somewhere.
Right.
I do like the fact that, like, just a tidbit, like, everybody was, you know, a lot of things getting talked about. These motherfuckers said, we've had ABCD issues. And until now, they've done a grand thing of, it's none of your fucking business.
Right.
All right. She's going to go over here and punch Batman or some shit. I'm going to go over here and shoot bullets at my digital self, whatever. You know, Icon's going to be living. Willow's going to have an acoustic fucking tour. And it's going to be great. And nobody's none the wiser. Because we keep this shit none of you motherfuckers' business.
Right.
And I was like, I dig it. I dig these.
You learn what we let you learn on a red table. And we getting paid for that, too.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, I think there is more to. And sometimes I be thinking, Will just got a sad face. It's either happy face or sad face. Because they was like, you know, everybody took this one clip. And I was like, I don't know, man. That nigga might not be ready to cry. Or cry because the reasons we won't. Like, we think he ready to cry. Like.
Even if he did cry, would it be tears of sadness?
Yeah, that part. I'm like Will might be a nigga like, I'm finna snap your neck, but when I get angry, I cry. So,
again, that's going to happen on the estate, and we're not going to know what's really going down. The only reason we know what's going down in their relationship right now is because of August.
Man, a fucking entanglement. What a term. Like, wow. I was in an entanglement. That's one thing
Can men get that off?
I don't know.
I mean, it's been thrown on the table that it can be used as a thing now. So can we get that off?
I don't know, because the going conversation now is y'all been getting it off for however long, and now
because technically we wasn't getting it off because people get mad just at how many pictures you liking on Instagram. So that's not getting away with anything or getting it off. And just because we don't call you on your bullshit publicly doesn't mean that you're not on bullshit.
Yeah, I guess that, like, I guess that could technically be like, to me, like, you know, you can't take a joke. I'm like, I can take a joke. I'm just saying, if we're going to try to find like even deeper thing, it's like this. Don't let this facilitate a wave, folks, of just now we can do bullshit. Because I think also just from very personal space, I'm like, no, man, like things like there are deep things. There are psychological things. And now because Jada and them, I think, take up a pseudo psychological space that if they do fucked up weird shit and say terms that nobody uses, I'm like, don't do that. That's not, you don't take these skills that you learn and then use them to justify your bullshit.
Right.
You use them to understand why you do a thing, understand your partner and all that great shit. Like, I don't want, I like the fact that some things that they've done, like, made it okay to talk about these things, made it okay to have safe spaces and shit. But I'm like, man, don't take this and now it's like an excuse. Man, Jada be doing bullshit too. So now everybody's back to square one on nigga shit.
Yeah, we're
like,
not doing that.
Don't do that.
Like, don't do that. You still have to exercise some bit of maturity within the situation. Which I think even them being able to have a conversation about it is relatively mature. So that's wonderful as well. All jokes aside, like, they are handling it like two relatively mature adults, as they should.
Yep.
Because if this was the stereotypical couple of black folks, it definitely would not. There would be no red table talking.
You was fucking this boy in my house.
Right. That's the nicest version that I could probably think of. Side note, should we be surprised? Because I think like Jada in multiple times has had movie roles where she was like with the younger guy or acted a fool. Like it was either one of the two.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not like, you know, I know art is art and work is work and all that other shit, but
art imitates life.
Yeah. I mean, I think, I don't know. I always feel like in any of these artistic spaces, like however much is, you know, you could be playing fucking, I don't know, for instance, I don't know, like fucking, like a Bane is a weird nigga to be walking around like in real life, but you do have to bring an aspect of yourself in that. Cause I be seeing Tom Hardy now and I'm like, when I look at him, like, I'm like, physically,
you ain't nah. But the movie helped.
Yeah, but I'm like, this nigga face look like he will beat you the fuck up. So he might not be ready to like take over Gotham and drop a nuke. But that part where Bane was just like even if it was these four scenes where that punch, that nigga does that punch. Like he likes that hook, that all these big body hook like that. Yeah, Tom will fuck you up. You a weird nigga. Like, so I will say, like, yeah, you kind of can sprinkle yourself. I don't know unless you like Daniel Day-Lewis, because I feel like they'd be like, yo, Daniel, like. He has to go live off in the woods to get it off his system because he's like, no, I became. They cast me as a giant squirrel creature, and I practiced for 6 months. Like, so, unless you're a nigga like that, like, yeah, I would say you got to kind of bring yourself to your art. So, you know. But, yeah, I do feel like I have, like, a lot of thoughts, though, because, like, I was watching that, and I fucked around and watched a little bit of Epstein, and I'm just like, this is, like, all this predatory shit was in my fucking head, like, you know, she's not Epstein bad.
No.
Like, not even close. But it's just like,
I mean, it's still considered predatory. But, I mean, if we really want to get to the meat and potatoes of it, especially within hip-hop culture and male culture, we have always heralded, say, pimps.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same kind of situation. You're prying on somebody whose mental health is not at its pinnacle for your own personal gain. It's the same thing. So, I mean, granted, one's getting money and the other one was just getting her cheek smacked. I mean, it's kind of a different situation, but it's kind of the same mentality. I'm taking somebody that's not in the right mind frame or emotional state for me to have a functional relationship with them,
yeah,
but I'm
like,
still taking advantage of it because I have the upper hand to make me feel good.
You're playing on, especially if you're somebody who, like, you know, as much history as they have, so you know, it's not even just like maybe some of that pimp shit where you know at a glance, you know, and I know you get to know your staple. But, you know, at like a certain glance, you might go, oh, she in the club wilding or whatever. So, you know, she probably off and you can bag that easy. Predatory.
Right. Yeah.
But Jada's shit seems like very, you could make a higher case because you had time to like really evaluate this man. Like he was really with y'all, some family shit. And then you was like, I'm having a bad go with my husband. So I'm going to go ahead and
look. You can find this clip later and add it into the video, but she's definitely Biggie Shorty from Pootie Tang.
Wow.
It's all right. Come on, baby. I'm going to take you home. We're going to get you together.
Big, boy.
You know I'm going to have sex with you too, right? All right. Come on.
Wow. Yes. And she was
most word for word, bar for bar. That's literally, Jada is Biggie Shorty, period.
Yeah,
Alcina is Pootie Tang. Shirt open, smooth hair, nigga.
Yeah, I definitely need Aug to, because even watching that interview, I was like, I know we're doing an album rollout. I know that's important, but also I really feel like you should just do a little more. Like I don't like how, and I think everybody does it now because now mental health's become important. So now everybody
stop bastardizing mental health, please.
Yeah, like now everybody will post a meme or you know, you might know the terms to say, but it's like, I can, like, when I watched his shit, I was like, you still got shit going on, but you know how to, like, present it now because you've heard a term or two.
Right.
To make it seem like I'm working on my journey. Are you? Because I just feel like you are putting a lot of, just the same way you don't need an entire thesaurus to talk about mental health and, like, to give somebody good advice and good guidance. You also, you know, don't take somebody giving you complete horse shit, but because they, like, fluff it up real good. Because I was watching that nigga shit, I was like, he's saying a lot of things here, but he's just presenting it very, I know what I'm doing and I'm on my journey and I'm not doing this. I just don't like when people talk about me as a person. Yo, she broke up with you. You're heartbroken.
Right.
You need to get some get back. That's how I felt about it.
That could be considered delusion. Like you're looking for something else to pass off what you're doing as opposed to addressing it directly and accepting it for what it is, good, bad, or beyond.
Yep.
So.
Yeah, that's one thing, like, not necessarily for, like, the drama of it all, but this situation, I'm like, there's a lot of good conversations that can come of this from multiple parties, how she's handling, how she did things, their relationship, how Will's handling, how he's doing things, their relationship, how, like we said, like we've even talked about August, like as much as I don't like August's maneuvers in this, how he went about it, the conversation that, oh, hey, man, like, niggas feel things,
right?
Like, and this motherfucker has gone through an entire existence of not even understanding what he feels, why he feels it, how he feels it, how he, those things. I think even though he has like a immunodeficient disease, I feel like, you know, everybody posting all this shit, and like, I love Dr. Sebi and all. Your mind affects your body, so now there's that conversation. Like, there's right. all these things that I feel like we could pull from here, aside from the memes that I also love posting because shit's just fucking funny. But
I won't even say it's things that we could pull from, because it's not stuff that we don't already know. I think the difference in this situation is, to go on my misogynistic rant.
Oh, here we go.
It's not really a rant, but because it's a man, we're paying a little bit more attention to it. Just like we've always talked about mental health in some capacity as it pertains to women, but it wasn't until Charlamagne popped up trying to talk about mental health on a regular basis, and I'll be like, oh, you're right, mental health is important, black people should pay more attention to men need mental health. Okay, because one person with some sort of platform or status says something, now it's important, but you didn't pay attention to it before. That's kind of the issue. So this is just another example of somebody being able to see that, yes, men suffer from stuff, and yes, men have struggles and issues, and yes, men aren't just the stereotype that we have, well, black men. I can't speak on, because some of these white folks, they are mentally ill.
Boy, is they doing it.
They are.
Motherfuckers is doing it.
But yeah, black men do have feelings, they do have emotions, they do have struggles, and you do have to pay attention to them, not just when it's for your benefit, Jada. Or should I say those like Jada? Because a lot of you guys prey on men, not just for finances, but some women prey on men in a emotional way.
I think she mentioned something like that. Like, she talked about how, you know, and there's a part of this that obviously can be used for a positive. Like, but she was like, I find myself looking for those that are broken, that are hurt, so I can help them. And it's like, okay, you know, you want to do good, but you can't be helping somebody so it feeds your ego. That's a
right.
some, yeah, that's, I don't know, that's some weird backwards
ass
shit.
If you come across somebody and you're willing to help them, help them along their journey as it doesn't impede yours,
mm-hmm.
then cool. But if you are going out of your way to find or quote unquote attract certain people that
niggas,
are of a certain.
Niggas read one law of attraction quote. And it was like, God damn. This is it.
It's energy. You attract what? Shut up. You are the negative energy you are attracting. It's your fault. But if you're going out of your way to try to find these things so you can feel self-righteous and make somebody feel better for yourself, that's a predatory issue. It may not even be that you're preying on them in a quote-unquote negative way, but the fact that you're utilizing them as some sort of a kickstart for your own self-esteem, that's an issue. Are you doing this because you really want to do it, or are you doing it because you think notoriety is going to make you feel better about yourself? It's kind of the same concept of all these people that do shit for the homeless, and you have to record it.
Mm-hmm.
If I wanted to be self-righteous, I could record shit all day at work. I don't. I mean, I get a paycheck for it. It's my job. But I do this because I enjoy helping the people. It's not about who's going to see it. It's not about, you know, who's going to, oh, even, I don't, half the time, I don't even tell people the population I work with because I don't want them to say, oh, that's so great. Look, I know. I didn't choose to go into social work for no reason. Like, I'm here because I want to be here. I don't need you to give me the kudos. But when you're searching for the kudos or using it to boost yourself up, you're not really doing it because you want to do it. You're not being authentic. You're kind of just full of shit.
Yeah. I want, you know, if there was a couple takeaways I like from this, but I definitely like that. And I'm like, yeah, I think I'm clearly biased, and I have I have a passion for this field.
Right.
So I'm like, don't take some of these things and these concepts that are really built to help, and you just, you know, I'm gonna, you know, learn a couple things, be able to say a couple nice things, and then completely fuck it all the way off. And then, you know, for this to be for on some like just bigger black scope shit, mental health became cool to us 48 hours ago.
Right.
So I'd be really worried that, like, you know, you can't have somebody, like, who's such a big, I guess, you know, that she's a big voice with, like, shit like this. This Red Table Talk thing is, like, a big-ass phenomenon. So it's like, hey, man, you gotta do it right.
Right.
Because, you know, you give too many motherfuckers an excuse to go, oh, see, man, that's what I be saying, that shit bullshit, and I ain't gonna
But even within it, it's still sort of an excuse. And this comment that I'm going to make isn't to shit on the Red Table. I think it's a positive thing that we have outlets that are promoting being able to talk and be vulnerable and get some alternative perspectives on what you're struggling through and be able to share your story. That's all fine and great. As somebody that works in mental health, my beef would be the only reason we're paying attention to it is because they're celebrities, but none of them are mental health professionals.
That part.
So we're putting all this talk of mental health in the hands of people who have not studied mental health, but we do not pay attention to or gravitate towards those that are qualified to speak on or talk about mental health. Again, it's not a beef on the show. It's a positive. We need more conversations like that. We need more conversations like that within the home, because it's great to watch it on TV because it's entertaining. And then you tell your kids, ain't nothing wrong with you. You just need Jesus or prayer or some bullshit like that. Like, no, it's a real thing, and we should be able to have these conversations on a regular basis.
What you going to therapy for?
What? You don't need no damn therapy. What am I paying this for? That's my tithes money. We're not doing that. But it is help creating a positive narrative, which I can appreciate. But again, they are not mental health professionals. So we do have to talk to people who have actually, I'm not going to say me, but you do have to talk to people that have the ability to actually exercise some actual discernment within talking about these topics.
Yeah, and I don't know, some of the shit takes, you know, I feel like clearly you've had it, like, oh, like a friend or whatever, oh, I know that you work in this. I'm like, yeah, but also, like, I feel like I'm pretty good at being objective,
right?
But I love and care about you, so you should go to somebody. I feel like, at least, not that you don't end up having a love and caring relationship with your clients, but at least we can kick this thing off from a space of, I don't know you, so I can give you a clean slate of how to address this, as
right.
opposed to just, oh, I know my friend Terry good. He got a good head on his shoulders. Terry, tell me all cool shit. You know, like, black fucking, whatever the fuck he said. I'm going to tell a Terry Crews shitty joke every week, folks, so strap in. fuck that nigga.
On your ass, Terry.
Every fucking time until he say something right. Fuck that.
So in other words...
But yeah, you just, like, you know, if you have a friend, like, it's great to have people in your life and use them for, you know, a safe space. But it should be a bit of a stigma taken off of, I can go to somebody who's a professional and, like, can really
right.
just air this whole thing the fuck out. Instead of, like, oh, I talk to Ashley, and Ashley's pretty smart, so.
Or the flip side, which I deal with, is because people know that I work in the field.
Oh, everything you say is.
Everything you say is like, oh, I'm not trying to come and be your therapist. Like, I didn't ask you to. I'm not trying to be your therapist.
Which
I'm not charging you.
Fucking.
Go ahead. Please.
Because if my friend is a fucking mechanic and I ask the nigga about car shit and he tells me some good shit about my car and it fixes it, why the fuck wouldn't I? I wouldn't be like, oh, this motherfucker up. And be like, oh, we drive. And he's like, hey, man. You probably should, you know, I can hear it and I can feel you. Maybe you should change your brakes
right.
because, you know, you don't do it in a little while. You know, it's going to fuck up all this other. Shut the fuck up, man. I know how to drive my goddamn car.
Okay.
Like, you wouldn't say that shit. Or if my other homie is a doctor and I'm coughing and I fucking spit up some phlegm and he goes, whoa, nigga, that's such, such and such and such. I didn't ask for no doctor shit and then I'd fucking die.
No, like, you do that, especially in the black community. We do it when we don't want to be accountable for the information that we're hearing, and we get defensive. So especially, like, say, in my personal experiences, like, ain't nobody asked you for your 2 cents. I just wanted you to listen. Like, technically, I'm qualified to do this. So my 2 cents are not 2 cents. It's actually a few dollars. If you really want to get into the specifics of this shit, and I'm not even trying to even help you with your issue. I'm just telling you because it's a red flag for me. And the shit that I'm telling you might get you the fuck up out of here. You don't address it. I'm actually working with you to communicate. And since you don't want to listen, and you feel triggered because I hit a nerve, now it's your 2 cents or my 2 cents that you didn't really ask for. Okay. Keep that energy when it comes to me keeping my money. How about that?
Yeah. Just, you know, I just want niggas to win. That's all. I just want y'all to just, you know, kick some of this shit together, motherfuckers, because Yeah, I don't know. I'm not one way or another with the situation, but I do like the, I don't know, realm of conversation. It's entangled. Just
black folks' hair is entangled when you get out the shower. What the fuck is entangled?
It's that I was in an entanglement. That like
it that was, is an avoidant answer.
Yeah,
that
was
that means
things,
you are lacking accountability. Even was, Will knew that he was like an man, entanglement, huh?
That was the thing I dug because like Will was like, "Come on, my nigga, like we're gonna do this for real.
If you're gonna do it for real, yeah. Like yeah, look." I'm not saying you have to be vulgar because I understand it's a platform, it's filmed. You have to address it a certain way on your TV show because there's people of all ages, races, nationality, and creeds that's watching. I get that. That's completely understandable. Be responsible with your platform. But also don't sugarcoat it.
Yeah, I mean, and I know it's still like, you know, you're not responsible 100% for like fucking adults because at the end of the day, I do think like their platform, like we've talked about, does open up a space for, you know, conversations and shit like that. But you could already tell off the bat of all the shit that was talked about in there, the shit that's blown up is her taking the word, saying entanglement, using that as a way to avoid and not be accountable. And that shit is what's blown up. Whether anyway or whatever, and I know I'm taking a super deep dive on this concept, but it's like, yeah, see, I'm like, you know, you almost damn near got to go into a conversation and be like, I'm going to go 100% balls to the wall truth because people will find a way, like you said, not to be accountable and go, oh, they said a lot of great shit. Entanglement is funny, and that's the takeaway. Entanglement and we're cheating now. And
I'll go on a deeper dive. That part of the conversation was a dynamic on their whole relationship, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
It's Will bringing something up, and let's talk about it. Her trying to find a way to justify it by not really taking accountability and addressing
it. It was like, you cheated.
And Will coming back and say, oh, is that what it is? No, 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 no. That's not what we're doing. And she said, okay, yes, I had a... It's not until he brings it up and says, nah, that bullshit ain't going to work on me. You know who you're talking to. Let's just be real about it, and it's okay.
And I don't know, yeah, like, and who's... Because I've, like, you know, he did have, like, they had a couple laughs, which I thought was kind of... Maybe real, maybe they're all right, we're gonna do this, you know, haha, bad. That's another thing I thought about right there, like bad marriage forever, and I'm like, don't say that shit.
No.
Now, yes, I think you get married and the idea is, yes, I wanna ride this motherfucker till the wheels fall off, whatever version of marriage you got. But I don't like that people, even the way niggas like have talked about it and, you know, jokingly, like the old ball and chain. If I'm going to ride this motherfucker out, the idea is to ride this motherfucker out happy, which
right.
requires both parties to, you know, say Will and, if we're going to keep using Will and Jada, they've clearly gone from this space to this space, and you have this person that you can maneuver through these changes. Because also, however you are now, if you got married tomorrow in the 50 year, I want to be 50, I want a 50 year love life, like, you're not going to be the same individual. So you would
not
need somebody who is going to be able to work through your changes. And you as well are supposed to be open to, I'm going to change as a person, and so
right.
on and so forth. So this idea that marriage becomes this fucking game of endurance as opposed to, oh no, like this is my friend, like my buddy, my pal, and we fuck. Or maybe don't fuck, or
right.
we fuck other people, or whatever
it is you feeling.
Yeah, whatever. But there's a real bond and not this, I don't know, relationship built on obligation, or this relationship built on like societal norms. Like, no, I chose you to be with you because I just fucking enjoy
right.
your space. And like, I feel like marriage should be, I feel like I've said this before, like marriage shouldn't be this, now we're married. Marriage should be damn near just icing on the cake. Like, this is a damn near like a celebration of our already established thing. But if marriage is what makes your thing, I feel like all these aspects would make marriage turned out not to be this grand fun thing that it's supposed to be.
Because marriage is kind of like mental health. It's been bastardized, and the foundation of it is really based on bullshit. Nobody's approaching it with the aspect of, me and this other person are working together to make something work functionally. Like you said, you gave the reference of the stereotypical ball and chain.
Mm-hmm.
No, if I'm going to have a weight on me within this relationship, it's going to be a dumbbell with weight. So as I'm pressing it, I'm getting stronger over time, and I can adjust the intensity as needed mm-hmm. to help me better myself. That's the weight that's going to be in this marriage, not a ball and chain that's weighing me down or an anchor. That's not why I'm getting into this situation. You're either going to contribute to my betterment, or you're holding me back, and we're choosing to address it as something that holds us back, then what the fuck are you doing it for in the first place?
Yeah.
You should be choosing something that's going to be beneficial for you in the long run and actually contribute to your betterment. If that's not what you're doing, then what is the real reason you're doing it for? Maybe padding your ego or covering up your insecurities to fill a void. A
couple of those
of
things.
Sorts.
Like, oh, I would love to not die alone. All right, cool. Well, now you're married. I would love to just, you know.
Newsflash. I don't give a fuck how long you've been married. You're still dying alone.
Yep. Yeah. Like
unless it's just a murder-suicide, which that's not positive at all. So. At the end of the day, you might as well just go ahead
y'all,
and...
Y'all can go lay on the train tracks like Leonardo DiCaprio in Inception.
No thanks.
It's a train coming. And you know it's the level y'all...
Look, that train can come. You can lay on them tracks if you want to. Or get a sandwich.
I don't know. This is not a fuck marriage or whatever you try to like institute your love, however, whatever. But the idea that the relationships are supposed to be this thing where you just, well, we together now, so
no,
nigga, I'm like, I already have to get up and go to work, and I like to go to the place. I want that to right. be a place that I like fucking going to. So why the fuck would you like? I don't know.
We treat our marriage the same way we treat our jobs.
Yeah, fuck that.
We do it just for the sake of doing it to have a means to an end, but we're not really invested in or happy with the shit. Like again, what's the point in doing it? People say, I can be bad all by myself, but then you don't choose to be by yourself when you probably should be by yourself. So really, you don't understand what the fuck you're doing. You just going with the wind.
Go away with that sentiment. You know, I thank Will and Jada for saying that line so I can remember. But yeah, like don't fucking do this thing of marriage is just or relationships in general. Like, and this is not saying you don't have yet. Ups and downs, right. bump heads. That happens in any form of relationship. Friendship, your mom and them, you know, your dog, whatever. Like, there's going to be, like, conflict. But this idea that, like, oh, I don't know. Yeah, it just becomes, like, to me sometimes, like, a big entitlement thing. Because it's like, okay, well, we marry now. And now, that's it. No, motherfucker. Like, you should still, once again, I think we talked about last week, a week before. Like, you're coming into these things and not coming from a space of giving. I want to just, I'm in a loving space. I'm going to give love. And that shit's supposed to, the law of attraction, bounce right. back to you. But if you're going in, what the fuck she done did for me? What the fuck he done did for me? You just, nigga, I'm just take. That shit going to run the fuck out.
Right. It has to be a mutual everything. A mutual everything.
And also, not to mention, like, just from like a, I don't know, like a time standpoint, like some of your best friends, you can get a best friend, probably, you know, you guys do a good solid 3 weeks. A lot of this motherfucker, we have a lot of great interests. But even those, I feel like people say things like we got close or whatever in a very short time span. I was like, that was probably a unprecedented level of openness that right. allowed that. So don't act like, you know, things don't deserve the time they need. Me and such and such been best friends since we was 12. But okay, so this took time for you to be whatever space you're in this friendship, relationship, whatever.
Right.
So, you know, there are just all these weird expectations and weird social things with how these things react. And that shit don't have to be that, is all I'm saying. Like, you could just not do that. I think Will and Jada also show that there is no one-size-fits-all way for this shit to work. And that's not just saying this as an excuse to go fuck around. Unless you want to fuck around, then, you know,
give each other the freedom to do so.
Find a motherfucker that you fuck around on some fuck around shit.
It doesn't even have to be fucking around. It's an agreement within our relationship. Because your relationship, regardless of what you want it to be or the dynamics around it, one thing that it should always be is fluid. It should always be able to be changing. It should always be able to maneuver in whatever situation or environment that you put it in. Why? Because you're not going to be the same people in the same environment the entire relationship. We spent a lot of time looking at Will and Jada like, oh, this is Will and Jada, Jay-Z and Beyonce, all black people like, oh, this is black love goals. The newsflash, in both relationships, somebody has cheated and they stayed and they tried to figure out how to make it work and they progressed past that or they're willing to talk about it. Y'all not even willing to accept somebody like not bringing you something to eat when they hungry and they asked you and you said you ain't want nothing and now you mad and you throwing a temper tantrum. Like, how are we supposed to last over silly shit like that? If you want the goals, you have to put in the work, period.
True.
Putting in the work means doing some shit you're uncomfortable with. And I know, like, we say quite often, like when something makes you feel quite uncomfortable, what do? You like,
you lean into it.
You just dive.
I also want to point out there that this is a shit on everybody. I'm shitting on men, women.
Oh, most definitely.
If you identify as a fucking box of Clorox, like
jar
I'm shitting
mayonnaise,
on all of
whatever
them.
You enjoy.
Yeah,
look,
like
everybody can get it. This isn't just trying to be misogynistic. I know we're two dudes talking on a podcast, so it may be directed towards women because we deal with women. But other than that, anybody can get it. If you're being irresponsible as an adult, then you're being irresponsible, and you have to take accountability for your shit, period. It doesn't matter what you have, testicles or fucking ovaries. There's still fucking balls that are in your body. It is what it is.
That
create hormones.
That's a lot. I'm not even, like, there's, I thought of, like, another fucking, like, meme I saw the other day. And
present it.
It was, like, it was a meme, and then I saw, like, a fucking, or was it a tweet? Whatever it is, it was a thing with words that I saw on the internet. But it was, and it's like a real conversation I think is going on. And I haven't done like a deep dive to feel like what's the both sides view on it. But I'll see it and I'll just see a lot of shit. But it's basically along the lines of, and I, once again, one of these conversations I need to have different communities in here, but whatever. it was like a transphobia thing. And it was like, oh, the fact that, yeah, it was like the fact that you don't want to fuck this person or date him. You're transphobic. Nigga, what? What? Like, what? I will beat a nigga up just so y'all can, like, you could, I want you to be able to do whatever you want to do, but right. Because I, and I'm like, doesn't that, what the fuck? So, like, that shit, I don't know. I'm like, okay, on a lot of levels, doesn't this counteract other things? Because you don't want to do, like, the regular shit.
No.
So,
no.
That makes you
speak freely,
heterophobic.
Speak freely and tell them how you really feel.
Like, that doesn't make any fucking sense. Okay. It just, it, I got, you know, not to, you could, what, that doesn't make sense.
It's fucking,
like,
just, stupid.
Yeah.
It's stupid. If somebody,
also, you're not going to suck that dick, bro?
Right.
You're a fucking bigot, bro.
Like, right. Get this. You're trying to, it's trying to, again, utilize your insecurities to push somebody towards a certain way as opposed to accepting accountability for it. No disrespect to the trans community, but you are a person that identifies as something other than what you are, which you have the freedom to do. But that doesn't mean that everybody has to accept it as such. If you are a man identifying as a woman, that's fine. But a straight man that is attracted to women is going to be attracted to women that are born women. It doesn't mean that they disrespect you as somebody that identifies as a woman, but you have to be willing to accept that I'm identifying as something. This is not what I am, and some people aren't going to see it that way. It's not always disrespect just because somebody is willing to stand firm in what they want, because you're standing firm in what you want as well, which is completely fine. We all have the freedom to do that.
Yeah, and I don't know. I feel like even, and I know it gets into whatever your side is, like a variety of probably gray, maybe, whatever. But I'm like, okay, where y'all, like, if I like my pussy stock, like, I want it off the lot that way. Like, I want it, you know, like, I went in there and it came off the, like, right off,
right,
the assembly line. Pussy. Cool. If you don't have one of those.
And you got one installed.
Not even, I'm going, but if you just, like, I'm not going to get it installed. I'm going to get these.
Or that, too, because you have that option as well.
Yeah. And so, I'll, like, you pull your goddamn drawers off. And I'm like, nigga, we got the same drawers on. Like, you need a room. Like, I need a room. What the fuck is.
Right.
So, now I'm at, like, what? I just, like, come on, man. Like, not even saying you shouldn't. And it, and I don't know, I think that's another thing too. Like, there's always these, not to say you should ever not have multiple conversations, because, like, in our community, there's, like, multiple conversations that should be had. But I'm like, wait a minute, bro. Like, I thought the conversation was you want to be able to live your experience freely without any type of barriers. Like, you shouldn't be beat up. You shouldn't be talked about. You should be recognized, like, you know, even as the black community, to bring us to the table. Like, they shouldn't just be out here getting murdered. Nobody says their names.
Right.
Like, all of that shit, perfect. But I'm like, come on, G. Like, where y'all? This is, I don't know what type of abuse or whatever, but this is fucking, like, you. Oh, so you just, wow, so you're not gonna,
right,
you're doing a lot. It's just a
lot. But that's also a lack of accountability. Just like, even in the example that you just gave, you made it all the way to the bedroom and didn't find out the truth until you got in there, which there are some scenarios where that has happened.
I've seen that conversation.
You're not, like, being accountable for your decision, and you're not being open enough to have that conversation with somebody beforehand and give them the choice, and you're taking that choice away from them, and then you're mad at them for not being able to have some sort of empathy for you when you didn't even give them an opportunity to be real with you.
Yeah, like, I'm aware that – And not aware, and I'm also like, you know, not aware because I'm not in that community. But like, yeah,
we don't fully understand it. I'm not supposed to understand it because that's not my community. But I also don't hate you simply because I don't understand everything. Let's just preface that.
I think
off
that's
top.
Well, that's another thing. Like me not being fully understand. I don't think I'll ever get it. But I would definitely. Doesn't mean like you can't be. And that's part of some of the argument. Like, you don't get it, but that doesn't mean you have to hate them for it. You just don't get it.
I just don't understand.
And not to just boil it down to fucking sex, but whatever. Like, I don't niggas that like to pee on people. I don't get that shit, but I ain't going to be like, man, fuck these niggas who like to pee.
Right.
It's just like, nigga, don't pee on me. Like, that's
right.
Like,
just, look, that's what you like that over there, and that's not what we do. As for me in my house,
yeah, I'm
that's
just,
not
I'm
that's not what's going on. Or I could be like, I agree. Yeah, I feel it. I know, fucks with it. I do it too. Whether you like to give or receive, that's still a different community. Say with you speaking with the topic of sex when it comes to subs and doms, like it's a different dynamic. Not all subs are going to understand all doms and so on and so forth. Like everybody just has their individual variances and their different preferences, which is completely fine. Whether you're post-op, pre-op, no-op, whatever it is that you're choosing.
I said, fuck the ops.
I didn't say fuck the ops. I did not. We're talking about these ops. I didn't say fuck the ops. Whatever ops you want, get your ops. But at the same time, be open and honest about what ops that you have had. Just, you know, the same respect that you would like to have from everybody else, you should be willing to give. And that's for any community. The black community, sometimes we got to be a little bit more understanding. I know we get on here and shit on white people quite often. Well, we don't shit on them. We're actually quite nice about it to a degree.
I feel like we just be telling the truth.
Right. We are. But also, the truth is subjective because some people may not accept that truth because they haven't been exposed to that information. So that kind of leads into the point, like, you have to be willing to have those uncomfortable conversations with people. But in order to do that, you have to be accountable for your part. You have to be able to say, you know what, this is me. This is what I'm feeling. This is what I'm presenting. And what is your portion?
Mm-hmm.
Listen to that and then say, okay, so how can we meet in the middle?
Solution-based.
That's solution-based, as opposed to somebody tells you their perspective and now you're upset and triggered and you're like, oh, you're gaslighting me because you're... No, I'm being honest with you.
Motherfuckers learn like two terms and I ain't shut the fuck up since. It's just wild.
Yeah, no, it's not gaslighting because I'm presenting my perspective and I'm holding you accountable to it if I'm also addressing the fact that I have some accountability within the situation as well. That's me being inclusive and understanding both perspectives or trying to have both perspectives addressed. I'm only gaslighting you if I try to make you look out to be the victim and I have no accountability within the situation. Just for those of you that want to throw those terms out and don't fully understand them. Like,
Yeah. I feel like that's one thing that confused me sometimes with that. I guess that argument that, you know, just because because I'm like, all right, man, because now you're the same way people try to box and force a motherfucker into, you can't be gay, you need to be straight, that's wrong, and so on and so forth. It's like, all right, man, if a dude says, I don't get down with
whatever you
this version of, like, your version of woman, I like my woman traditional, or whichever way you want to say it, that's a little, I don't know, it's oppressive, I guess, right?
Like, I mean, that's kind of it. To a degree, it is, and it's closed-minded. But that's also how we're approaching the whole Will and Jada situation. Their marriage is their marriage. It's not our business to critique their marriage. So if they took a break and she got some penis on the side, however predatory or not she may have went about doing it, there's really nothing for us to discuss because they were on a break and they were cool with it. And they're having a talk about it as a married couple, and they're not raising an issue. So what the fuck do we have to say? It's their marriage, and they're okay with it, at least presenting on TV, because I don't know what Will was like once they got to the crib.
But even, I don't know, even that is a good way, like, to me, I mean, presenting as far as, like, okay, we could talk about it. We could talk about something we're not comfortable about, but you could still do it respectfully. Like, they did a lot of good things on that shit. Like,
most definitely.
I might have been taking, like, a lot of deep dives, but I was like, they did a lot of good things. Cool. I'm going to talk about the hot shit, because the hot shit is hot
shit. For content purposes. You got to be entertaining.
But, yeah, like, they did a lot of shit that I was like, okay, man, this is good. And honestly, the way, and it's weird that, and I don't know if it's just because of how they got down or because Will was, like, Fresh Prince and he was, like, you know, the getting jiggy nigga who doesn't curse. And, like, even Jada, like, even though she had, like, has had, like, a lot of adult movies and stuff, roles, I guess, so to speak, But she's kind of like household name-ish.
I'm about to say, because you said Jada got a dope movie, so I was about to go right to the search engine.
Yeah. Sorry. Let me clean that up because I feel like we niggas. I mean, she might. We'll never see him, but I believe that, man, she probably got quality work, like good films.
Her dressed up as Fish Mooney, just getting right
man,
to it.
Man, like, look, they got whole. Is the Red Table in their house?
I don't know. But
you know, they got access to film crews and shit. Like, they do good. They've had some good shit, probably. Like, and they, you know, they lived through, like, you know, before the internet was booming. So they were able to do, like, just trash. Like, there are probably people now that they know. That's where I was headed to. Everybody doing fucked up, well, different shit.
Right, different.
And we all know, we all have always, it's weird. Like, you sit at home, you watch these movies, you go, you sit in the, like, everybody's had them. You sit around your living room talking to your friends. I bet motherfuckers is whoop, 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 whether it's evil government shit or whether it's weird sex shit. Whether
it's a
super
little bit of everything.
Yeah, whether it's whatever. And then, like, when the shit's presented, everybody goes, I can't believe.
You can't believe, because a lot of you motherfuckers was the ones that went out and was, you know, just hyping up 50 Shades of Grey when that movie came out and the book came out. But then you see some real 50 Shades of Grey type shit happen in real life, and you're like, oh my God, that's...
Dog, I've never... Just, and I know this is, like, maybe telling on my dirtbaggery. I don't feel free. I stand
with you.
Yeah, I don't know the name of the thing, but everybody knows, like, there was a meme out, and only dirtbag motherfuckers was catching, but, like, that castle... And you know, like, that castle, like, pops up right before the fucking, you go to a little sex dungeon place. But it's, like, it's in
I thought you were talking about Eureka's castle. My bad.
Maybe. But it's like.
It's definitely not.
But it's, like, yeah, you know, like, you'll see, like, it looks, I don't know, it's like a castle, like an old-timey English building or whatever, but it's just big as fuck.
Nothing good happens in there.
And then, like, after that, it'll be a scene, and they just be in a dungeon. They be doing, like, real fucking dungeon shit. Like, it was one I saw. And I'm like, this was some wild shit. Like, it's like a bunch of tape, and they wrap him up like a mummy. Mm-hmm. And the only thing is ass and puss out. Mm-hmm. And they was back just fucking. Now I'm like, this is some 50 Shades shit. Like, that's why I'm like, and I'm not even trying to, like, slang porn, but it's like, anytime it was like 50 Shades, just it gets me so that what does it? Because honestly, this is what
it really is.
Do you see that thing? I don't even know how you build that thing she hanging on, and it's like a little. It's a butt.
It's not as
like
hard as you think.
They got the butt plug hook. And then, like, man, shut the fuck up talking to me.
It's all pretty dummy proof. I mean, you can go to the sex store and see it all. It's really not hard to find. If you really want to see these things, you're really into it. Like, if you're really into it, then go do it.
Yeah. Like,
you got the freedom to do so. It's not hard to find. Like, there's tons. Of, I mean, even if you just want to go on Adam and Eve and just order some shit, nigga, you can.
That 50 Shades shit, I'm like, man, look, this shit is.
It's real. There's a difference between. Fantasy and reality.
I feel like that's some safe. I want to be a fake freak shit. Like, I know it's cool.
Right. It's
like,
cool,
I'm
and
in,
it looks
I'm
good.
Into the shit, like,
until somebody actually take one of them whips and crack you upside your ass. Not that hard. No, this is how it's supposed to go.
Yeah,
what do you mean?
Yeah, that nigga say, lock in, strap in. Wait, you going to take your clothes off? Nope, not for a while. I ain't. Just,
nope. It's going to take me a minute.
Yeah, we're going to sit here a minute. I'm in for the show.
You signed the NDA. You know what
that
it
nigga
is.
Said, yeah, nigga show up. Your brother, your sister, about to crack those fucking cheeks. this is not the sex. Yeah, you cut none of this sexy ass music in here, man. It's
none
a,
at all. Yeah, you what's to say for it? Flugenhagheimen.
Yep.
You said Flugenhagheimen?
No,
find that clip and add it in later, too. That's a Euro Trip reference for those of you that don't know. It's okay. It's a pretty, pretty funny movie. Lots of white, stupid teenery going on, but it's kind
of
old.
That was an age of movies, man. Like, they had a good stint. What else people do now?
All those white people college movies.
Yeah,
where
they just
doing,
like,
dumb shit. I enjoyed, like, them because it made somebody else look stupid other than us. So
it was like the same. They did like 25 of the same movie, and like niggas watched every one of them.
I mean, it's a lot of privilege, but
yeah. Like, what do y'all do? What are they doing now? Like, because the ones that just got, I know, like, some of them just got stuck in like that. Like, thing. Like, oh, I'm this fucking goofy comedy person.
Right. And once it hit, like, 2005, 2006, it was a wrap for them type of movies. Like, what you got next?
Yeah.
When people stopped frosting their tips and shit.
Yeah,
boy bands are no longer a thing.
Yeah, I wonder. I mean, I know actors do. I see, like, actors do it now where they bounce around. But I'm like, yeah, what do y'all do? Like,
porn.
Yeah. I mean, I guess, like, now you can just kind of go in. And you want to be more like diverse, because if I was coming, I'd be like, I want to act, I want to do a comedy, then I'm gonna do an action shit, then I'm gonna do some deep drama that costed $50,000 to make. I would Shia LaBeouf the fuck out this bitch.
You don't want to do like Attack of the Killer Snowman 5.
I don't.
I mean, that probably took like $20,000 to make. But
yeah, I don't know, man. Cause shit like that be going off, so might have to cut the check. 4:30 gets here fast, and I don't got no exit for y'all. Except we're doing more Will, man, because
it's appropriate.
This the energy Will finna come back on. If you like this shirt, it's a Revolutionary Mind shirt. You see it. I don't know everything it says on here, but do that. And support dope.
Talks about
shit.
Doing some shit that you should be doing in the first place if you black. God damn it.
And that's it. See you guys next week on Thursday. And, you know, stay entangled or disentangle. I don't fucking know, man. Fuck somebody.
Stay
kiss
active
them in the mouth.
On the IG page, especially as it pertains to our giveaway.
We're giving
money. Giving away.
We're giving monies.
You're giving away an opportunity to build your business. So, support, or support somebody that needs support. One of the two, but it's summertime.
Okay, bye.
August is summer.